Good morning all. Myself Chaitanya and I am from the company called 7 Arrows. We are into actually providing of interactive solutions and digital solutions to schools and colleges, especially for online classes as well as recording of classes. As if you can see, as of now, we are actually using an interactive LED touch panel and we are using one USB camera which is connected to this particular panel through a USB cable. And we are actually giving a demonstration on how a class can be recorded during this time so that we can record the class and pass on to the students, or else we can actually go for a live meeting with the students. For a live meeting, we can use a live app like Zoom or WebEx or InstaVC or any of the application so that we can give them a live demo. And as of now, I'm using one particular software which comes with the interactive panels nowadays, that is known as Note. So I will just demonstrate morely about Note and then see how good is the demonstration done. So that is the thing. Now let me show you. In this particular Note software, there is a pen tool. So there is a pen, brush, highlighter, then a small brush and a vanishing brush. And another thing, and all the colors are there. Now I'm just selecting some color like blue, and I can even change the size of the pen. And after that, I can just have to click on this, and I can write on top of the surface so that it acts like a normal board, right? And after that, I can keep on adding pages. Now I have added one more page, and now the thing is, there is one more tool which is known as shape recognition tool. So I will draw something near to a circle, it will automatically get converted into a circle, and something near to a triangle, something near to a rectangle, rhombus, something near to a rectangle, something near to a square. So all these standard shapes can be basically it can be recognizing it. And even there are some more shapes that can be drawn. If I just draw, it gives us this particular thing. We can actually just expand it, do different shaping on that, and we can actually even delete it if we don't want that particular line to be there. And we can actually straight away go for some standard shapes. We can select the shape, or we can take the intelligent identification pen, which is the shape recognition pen, and then we can write. So both the things are possible. Next, coming to one more particular tool, that is a handwriting recognition tool. I will just select this handwriting recognition tool and I'll write something on top of this. So I have wrote India on top of this, which will automatically get converted into a standard format. After that, I can just actually select this particular thing and ask it to read out. So it is having a particular inbuilt speakers, which are 20 watt speakers. So if you see, I just selected it, and after that, so now I have put a line under this which it has taken as underscore, and now when I am asking it to read out, you can listen it. So it is basically reading as India underscore. So you understand ki how good and how effective it is, right? And after that, when I took a normal pen and I start teaching something, and I have started writing something on top of this, so now as if this is a 55 inch, the screen is not limited to 55 inch, vertically or horizontally, any direction we can keep on writing. So I can just take it up and I can select the pen, I can continue with my step. So once I am done, I can actually zoom out all the things into one single screen and I can show it up. So that is also possible. So these possibilities are also there in it. And other than that, there are some tools, like if you see, this is a mask tool. So why a mask tool is to be used? Like, so if I just copy something or write something, some question on top of this, and I will just reveal it slowly and ask the students that I will give you a 30 seconds time, you can actually solve that question, and after that I will reveal the answer to them, and after that again I will go for one more question, then an answer. So in this way we can actually make the class more and more interesting and interactive between the teachers as well as the students. So that is also possible in this. And there are many other tools in this, like we can just select a spotlight and take the spotlight. We can increase the size of the spotlight. We can move it anywhere we want on the screen, right? So that is possible. We can convert it into a square and all these things can be done. So we can actually see that the background is completely highlighted or it is done, and we can close it also. So that is also possible in this. And other than that, if you see here, one more, there are so many other options. Let me show a few of them, right? If I'm doing one maths problem, I will say 632 into 27, I just want to write the answer. Then what will I do is I'll select this whiteboard. So 632 into 27, right? So I will do all the calculations here. So whatever calculations I will do, I will get it done. I'll just close the small board and straight away I will write the answer. So that is also possible here. So in this way, rather than disturbing the main screen, we can actually just add on one more screen for just doing some rough work on that, right? And one more thing, like if you see, now these are all the sheets that we have done. Somebody has a doubt in the second slide. If somebody asks us to go back to the second slide, we can straight away go to the second slide and then basically explain him to the about the second slide, and we can come back to our present slide. So that is also possible. And not only that, clicking on this option, we can export all the slides which were already recorded into a image, a Word, a PPT or a PDF, whatever format we require, so that whatever we have taught in this particular class can immediately be sent to the students. So that is also possible in this. Now let me see one more small thing. Like right now what I am doing is I am just opening one particular drive in my particular computer, and I have opened one video in this bird prey video, which is actually one of my most favorite videos actually, right? So now you can see, okay, yeah, so now you can see this is one particular video which I like the more. So I can just pause it, and once I pause it, after that what can I do is I can take the pen, select any pen, any color, like select the yellow pen. Then what will I do is I will explain to the students. So this is a eye, so this is a beak. So in this way I can actually explain on top of the video without actually disturbing my original video. Once I am done, one click, everything is gone, I can continue with my video, right? You understand? So it's very actually interactive in that way. Now let me go a bit forward. Yeah, now let us see, I have paused in this particular place of this video. Then what will I do is I'll actually just take this screenshot tool. I will select it and leave it. It will automatically come to our note software, right? Hope it's interesting, right? So now what can we do is we can zoom it, zoom out, right? We can actually now take and tell people. See, if you are able to, you are not able to see, I'll just show you. Okay. I'll select the eraser tool, right? Okay, then if you see, I have selected this shape and by mistake, so I have erased it. Now what will I do is I'll zoom this. Okay, I'll zoom it, and now what will I do is I'll select and show this particular band which is kept on to this particular bird's leg. So why this band is particularly put is just to track where exactly it is moving, what is its lifestyle like in National Geography or in another other wildlife channels. What do they do is they catch hold of these birds and actually they put this ring so that they can actually track their movements. So this is possible, right? So in this way, I can actually deeply explain what exactly I want to do. And once I'm done, I can add one more sheet, minimize this thing, go to my video, continue with my video. So from my video, I'm able to extract something even, and I am able to take it to the place where I actually required. So this is one way of using this particular board, right? And after that, let me do one more good thing. Okay. Yeah. So what I'm doing is I'm just trying to open one PDF. Okay. So this is one particular PDF which I have downloaded. Okay. Now I have taken the mask tool. So why? Like as if I have told you that we can record and show the questions and reveal them one by one. So every time we can't write the questions and then start doing it. So we may have a PDF in which all our questions are there. So here will be my first question, which I will reveal. After that, I will go for my second to the answer. Then a second question. So once a PDF is made or any other document, Word document is made, after that we can do the revealing tool. We can use it and actually show it. So that is also possible. It's not that key something is written in the note, then only we can do it. It's not like that. So in this way, we can actually use this possible, right? So this is, there are some more good features in the Node software. We can actually still give further trainings and actually give a full-fledged demo on this. So this is the way. And now as if you have seen, actually whatever we were doing, everything was getting recorded. So this is one tool which is known as a capture tool, which comes default with the LED panels. So which is actually used to record the classes. So now I am actually just pausing it or stopping it. Thank you. Signing off, Chaitanya from 7 Arrows.